Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about neonatal resuscitation. This is a concise presentation for medical students. Neonatal resuscitation is also known as newborn resuscitation. It is an emergency procedure. Around 10% of newborns don't readily begin breathing. They are at risk of irreversible organ injury and death. To prevent these, we have to follow the neonatal resuscitation algorithm. Now let us see about the neonatal resuscitation algorithm. At birth, we need to assess three things: whether the baby is term gestation, whether the baby is breathing or crying, whether the tone is good. If answer to all these questions is yes, we have to provide routine care and the baby should stay with the mother. Routine care includes providing warmth, clearing airway if necessary, keeping the baby dry, and ongoing evaluation of the newborn. If the answer to any of these three questions is a no, we have to give warmth to the baby, we have to clear airway if necessary, and we have to keep the baby dry. In addition, we have to stimulate the baby. After 30 seconds of stimulating, we have to check the heart rate. If the heart rate is less than 100 and if the baby is gasping or if there is apnea, we have to give positive pressure ventilation and we have to monitor SpO2. This should be done within 60 seconds. If the heart rate is greater than 100 and if there is no gasping or apnea, we have to assess for labored breathing or persistent cyanosis. If the answer to all of these questions is a no, we have to continue routine care. If there is labored breathing or persistent cyanosis, we have to clear the airway and we have to monitor SpO2 and we can consider continuous positive airway pressure. Now let us see about the targeted SpO2 in newborns. The targeted SpO2 depends on the minute of birth. At 1 minute, the target is 60-65%, at 2 minutes, the target is 65-70%, at 3 minutes, the target is 70-75%, at 4 minutes, the target is 75-80%, at 5 minutes, it is 80-85%, and at 10 minutes, it is 85-95%. The SpO2 should not be more or should not be less than this. After providing positive pressure ventilation and monitoring SpO2, we have to check for the heart rate. If the heart rate is greater than 100, we have to provide post resuscitation care. If the heart rate is less than 100, we have to do ventilation corrective steps. An acronym to remember ventilation corrective steps is Mr. Soap. M stands for mask adjustment, R stands for repositioning airway, S stands for suctioning mouth and nares, O stands for opening mouth, A stands for alternate airway, and P stands for increasing pressure. After ventilation corrective steps, if the heart rate is less than 60, we have to consider intubation after chest compressions when there is no chest raise. The chest compression should be coordinated with positive pressure ventilation. After all these, if the heart rate is less than 60, we have to consider IV epinephrine. IV epinephrine should be given till the heart rate is greater than 60. If the heart rate is greater than 60, we have to come back to this step. Remember, we have to intubate the baby only if there is no chest raise. And in this case, we have to consider hypovolemia and pneumothorax. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. If you like my videos, please subscribe. Your subscription will encourage me to make more videos. Thank you.